Okay, so the very first step is to cream the butters and the sugars for 2 minutes. So this is the butter, this is the 1/3 a cup, which is 5 1/3 tablespoons of butter. And this is the 1/2 cup of brown sugar, packed. I'm using light brown sugar. And 1/3 cup of white sugar. We're going to put that all in our mixer, and this is my mixer, and we're going to put it on medium speed for 2 minutes. Until combined and kind of fluffy, that's what you want it fluffy. Okay, so that's kind of what you want it to look like after it's all mixed. I don't know if you guys can see that. And now you want to put the mixer back on. You can scrape down the sides, but I'm going to scrape it out after I put the egg in because I like doing that better. You're going to add your egg. This is one egg. It's already cracked. This is one egg, which is already cracked. You're just going to add that in. Crank up the mixer a little bit. And then you're going to add your 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Pure vanilla. Don't use imitation vanilla like defeats the purpose. I'm going to slow this down a little bit. And you're going to add your vanilla. Scrape down the bowl. Make sure you get underneath. And I just wipe the spatula off on the paddle. And we always use the paddle brush for baking. We never use the whip one unless we're using, I don't even ask you, we never use the whip attachment unless we're making like whipped cream or something. So you just want to mix this until combined. And that looks pretty good. So we're going to slow this down because now we're going to be adding flour. You don't want to have your mixer on high when you're adding flour. So this is the flour, the baking soda, and the salt. And I use sea salt when I bake. I use sea salt for everything basically. If I ever add salt, it's always sea salt. Because it's a little bit healthier for you than regular salt. So we're going to gradually add our flour in just a little bit at a time. And then combine that. And slow it down. I just add till combined and then I'll go back and really mix it in. And scrape down a bowl again. And this batch only makes 24 cookies, so that's why it's not a lot. Usually I double it, but we don't need that many cookies. Oh, my brother doesn't need that many cookies. And then the last little bit. Turn that off. Scrape down the bowl. it all together for a few seconds. And you're gonna scrape everything off the beater. And then mix it together. And I also forgot to say you need to preheat your oven. My oven just automatically heats up. It doesn't really have preheating setting. I'm going to put it on 375. So on an ungreased cookie sheet, you are going to put these out. Now these don't spread out that much, so you can kind of put them close together. The recipe says to do about 2 inches apart, but you don't have to technically do it. I just put a big heaping spoonful, some of this oil in the pan, into the section, just like that. And I like to bake my cookies one pan at a time, so I'm going to pop this in the oven. And then we're going to do the other pan, and I'll see you guys in a second. So the cookies are in the oven, and it is going to bake on 375 for 8 to 10 minutes. So I'm going to put my timer. And I put it on 9 minutes in between 8 to 10. And 375. So the cookies are done. I'm just going to take them from the pan and put them on the cookie sheet, which is right there. And yeah, I'll show you the finished product when we're all done. So these are the done cookies. They need to cool off. But they are 100% done, and this is what they look like. Like I said, they don't really, I'm talking really fast. Like I said, they don't really spread. They kind of just stay in the shape that they are in for the most part. But, because they don't have that much butter in this baking soda. But these are what they look like. They're like really hot because they're straight out of the oven. But, yeah. So these are my white chocolate cranberry cookies. I hope you enjoyed my tutorial or my baking with Brie, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!